Hello everyone. Today we will learn file and input output with C#.NET language. I am your instructor Kruti Patel from LG Institutes of Engineering and Technology. What is file and IO? A file is a collection of data stored in a disk with a specific name and a directory path. When a file is opened for reading or writing, it becomes a stream. The stream is basically the sequence of bytes passing through the communication path. There are two main streams, the input stream and output stream. The input stream is used for reading the data from file, and the output stream is used for writing the data into the file. Here you can see we have a multiple C# input output classes and its descriptions are mentioned here. First is binary reader. It reads the primitive data types and binary values in a specific encoding. Second is binary writer. Same way it is used for writing purpose. Next is buffered stream. Adds a buffering layer to read and write the operations. Next is directory. Directory will exposes the static method for creating, moving, and enumerating through the directories and subdirectories. Directory info expose the instance methods for creating, moving, enumerations and through directories and subdirectories. Next is directory not found exception. The exception that is thrown when part of a file or directory cannot be found. Next is drive info. It provides the access to information on drive. Next is stream reader. Stream reader is used to implement a text reader that reads characters from byte stream. Same way, stream writer class is used for performing writing purpose. String reader is used to implement text reader that reads from a string, and string writer is used for implementing the text writer for writing information to a string. Now we will see how these classes are used for input and output purpose. For that, we will see different programs. The programs are listed here. You can see, we'll see first program, the practical demonstration to read the lines from a file until the end of the file is reached. Means we will read the whole file lines which are written in particular file. Next is practical demonstration to list the files in a directory. Third one is practical demonstration to read the username from keyboard and save it in a text file. And last one is the practical to get the directories and subdirectories and also list the files from it. For first program, to reading a line from a file until the end of file is reached. For that, I'll open Visual Studio. So here, Microsoft Visual Studio 2010. I'll open first program for file input output, which I have written priorly. Here you can see this program is for reading the line from file until the file end. Here, for this purpose, you can see first namespace using system.io is enclosed. Here I have taken one path variable which stores path from d drive and t1.txt file, which is stored in string type variable. Next, I have used stream writer class for writing purpose. So whenever I create object of this SW, I passed path as an argument. Then after, I have written console.writeline, enter the text to save in the text file. means whatever the text we want to save in our file, it will be written here and it will be inputted from user. So it will store in text from user variable, and that text from user variable will passed as an argument in WriteLine method. But note this point, this WriteLine method is not from console class as usual, but it is of a StreamWriter class because its object sw.WriteLine is written here. Now, StreamWriter's close method is invoked. So sw.close, it will used to close a writing mode. Then after, it will printed saved successfully in our output screen. Then I have created object of StreamReader class. So here SR is created object, and same way as SW, we need to pass a path as an argument. So here you can see path is passed, and in console.WriteLine, readLine method of StreamReader class is invoked. So reader will read the line. It will read the whole line till end of the file. Whatever it will be written by reader, it is printed in our console output. So console.WriteLine having the argument which read it by reader file. So last, it is our static window purpose of output. It will not write this line. The output screen will not statically stop in our screen. Now I'll run this code. You can see here, enter the text to save in text file. I'll write hello and I'll press enter. So saved successfully. This hello world is saved successfully, and it is also written by string reader class. Same way, you can also give this example wherever asked by use of StreamReader and Writer. Now I close this Visual Studio and we'll see the next code, that is practical demonstration to list the files in a directory. Means from any directory, how many files and which are the files are there, which will be written by compiler. So here for this Visual Studio 2010 and second program, that is file IO2. You can see here same way as prior program, I have enclosed this system.io namespace. Here you can see directory class is used and get file method is written. Get file method will get the files from a specific directory, but as an argument we need to pass a path. So here get file having the argument /drive:// I have written here the name of main directory, means here in D drive I have software folder and I have multiple these files here in my computer. So I have passed D drive and software folder. So now console.WriteLine files in the directory. Now this code will print that particular files from D drive and software folder. So for each loop, string name variable is taken here and in array 1. So here our files are stored in variable that is named array 1, and it is the type of data type string. So here console.WriteLine and here these files name is printed. So when I run this code, you can see output here from D drive, software folder, abc.doc, Adobe Reader, these all files are listed which I have in software folder. You can see these all files are listed in our output screen. So you can say it is a program to list your files from a directory. Next code. Next program is of demonstration to read the username from keyboard and save it in a text file. Now we will take any data or any username or any variables or any input from user, and it will be saved in our text file. For that, in Visual Studio, I'll open third program, that is file io3. You can see here I have taken this path ddrive-software-test1.txt, which file path is priorly given here in a name variable path, which is type of string. Now string text from user is here variable for getting the text from user. In try block, I have written this exist method of file class. So if file.exist, if this file is existed, then this file will be deleted. Okay. And here stream writer sw equals to new stream writer path. So here stream writer path will assign any data. This file is deleted because if we have created this file priorly, then some data will be there. So no, we don't need any this data. So we'll first delete it, and whenever I'll execute this writer class, it will create automatically this file. So here, if this file is existed, then first it will be deleted and will create new file while writing. So enter the text to save in the text file. Whatever the text will be written, it will be saved in text from user. It will be written as we have seen priorly. Data will be saved successfully. And here from reading stream reader object SR, it will be read the file from end and from the read to end method. And if anything goes to wrong, the exception will be handled. The process is failed. So here now we'll see. I'll run this code, enter the text to save in file. Hello everyone is my text. I'll press enter. Data will be saved successfully and it will be hello everyone. Now I'll see in test1.txt file, hello everyone data is saved. So here you can see our data is saved in our file. So now in such a manner, you can take an input from user. You can also check the file's existence. You can also write here file.create method also if you want to create here. And if you don't want to create from file.create method, you can also create that file from stream writer class also. Same way, we will see last program, that is practical demonstration to get the directories and subdirectories and also list files from it. For it, I'll open program file open project. And our last program of file is file io4. You can see here it is a file program which get the directories and subdirectories and also files from main directory. Now enter the main directory drive name to get the directories. So we'll enter any drive name. It will be fetched by user and it will be stored in DI1. Here we have taken a new class, that is directory info. Whatever the data will be inputted by user, it will be stored in DI1, and then of DI1's method, directory info class having a method that is get directories, but here star and search option dot top directory only represent that we are searching for all directories. Okay, So here, whatever the directories are fetched, it will be stored in info array of type directory info. So here I'll print those directory names from for each loop. So directory info item in info, the item name will be displayed. So it will print all the tape folders of main drive. And here, if you want to also print, you can see this output first. If I'll write D drive, then you can see here, these are my main folders of D drive. So these are printed, Recycle Bean, Hardik, Kruti, Movie, NDK, Path, etc. You can see in D drive, I have these folders which are listed there. Next, we'll see how fetch the files. These are code for only fetching directories. But if we want to access the files of the directory, we need to write here get files method in place of get directories. So here, same way we have taken another variable of directory info, that is di, sorry, another object of directory info, that is di2, and it will take any data. So we have to write here any directory and folder name for which we need to print the files. Then after, in place of directory info, the files are stored in file info type array. So here we have taken the array name, that is file info of type file info data type. It is also a class, so we can use this method. So for each file info, items in finfo. So the files which are from that particular directories are listed here through this for each loop. So when I'll run this code, it is for directory, and also ask enter the folder name to get the files. So I'll write here D colon drive, and I'll write any of the folder name, that is Kruti. So when I'll press enter, it show me all the files which are under my folder, that is Kruti. So you can see here, these are XLSX files because I have mentioned specific version here. All Excel files I needed. If I don't want any Excel file, I can write only star over here. You can see its output, particular files, and in above code, these are particular directories which are displayed. So thank you, everyone.